这段热情洋溢、充满青春的朝气与活力的舞蹈，想必大家都记忆犹新吧。在文化节上，美国交流生们的舞蹈 All Star 打动了每一位观众的心。来自美国牛顿公立学校的十名师生，在1月24日已经开始了为期4个月的交流活动。来自美国的朋友与我们的交流，不仅增长了我们的见识，还让我们目睹了美国青年自由洒脱的美式青春激情。美国交流生在我校开设了英语角，每天中午12:40，同学们可以去天津的英语角与美国同学们练习英语，在交流的同时增进感情。美国同学们开设的英语角成为了景山校园里一道亮丽的风景线。
宋宇同学，我听说你参加了我们学校的英语角这个活动，那请问一下啊，就是你觉得和美国交流生聊天与和中国人聊天有什么不同呢？就是特别属于那，就是特别是说英语的方面。
就是因为毕竟是另外一种语言，所以他们有的时候有口音，而且说话的时候有时候比较快，然后这个使得交通不是那么容易，而且在文化方面有一些差异，所以到他们一起在学校的一些事情。
So why do you guys come up with the English corner idea?
We didn't come up with it, and I'm starting to think that Newton didn't come up with it either. Because there's a park near my house that has English Corner.
Yeah, it's a thing.
Yeah, but
it's
like a legit sign.
We were told it's a tradition.
Alright, then how do you teach Chinese students English?
We just speak. Yeah, we just do open dialogue and talk about whatever
students want to talk about.
Yeah, and so we'll go over a new word if they don't know it, but otherwise we don't run like a class.
All right, thank you. And third one, what do you learn from the teaching experience?
I wouldn't say it's much of a teaching experience, but making friends kind of experience.
Definitely making friends and learning about what the students think about, what they care about, what culture they're exposed to, including Western culture. By knowing what English words they know, can really tell a lot about the student and what they've been exposed to.
来到我校交流的美国师生，不仅在我校充分感受到了中国校园的气氛，目睹了中国学生的风采，也在校外探访华夏名胜古迹，领略了中华文化的魅力。美国同学来我校交流了4个月，感受到了中国，特别是中国学校的特色和文化。同样，参加交流项目的我校同学也有一个别开生面的经历，他们一定有很多所思所想要跟我们分享。
The biggest difference for me is the culture surrounding individualism and people's place in the community.
And what do you think of the students here?
Well, I think the students here spend too much time studying.
Oh, that's true.
And they have too many classes. They don't hang out with friends. They don't, there's learning that you do in school, obviously, but there's also learning that you do
outside of school.
Outside of school.
Like learning social skills.
Yeah.
Learning how to,
The emotional IQ, which is actually something you can measure.It's something that people care about. My favorite food is mapo tofu.
All right, that exactly very good.
I really like gulai ro. It's such an American Chinese food.
Yeah.
It's a Cantonese dish that's like really sweet.
Yeah. So we've been doing, you're talking about like calligraphy class and...
Calligraphy class. Talk about that. It's very interesting.
Well, I think it's been interesting to learn about Chinese culture, but at the same time, those classes aren't very academically engaging, and they're not really at our level. Calligraphy, it's interesting to know about the culture, but I don't really need to be a good calligrapher. It's not important. I'd rather spend my time learning about something else.
One of the things that has happened here is we've asked for, earlier in the year we didn't have as many classes as we do now, and we asked to have more classes later in the year. And we were expecting to have classes like political science or comparative economics or something that really has to do with both China and the U.S. and has to do with, you know, the basic structure of, you know, that's studying the culture in a more sort of broad sense of the word, you know, like actually the interactions between the countries, things like that. But instead we got things like arts and crafts, which are nice and they're relaxing, but
it's not what we want to be doing.
Yeah.
为期四个月的短暂交流活动即将结束了，但是两校间已建立三十余年的友谊仍将继续，并为一代代中美青年建立毕生的友谊。